This is the story of thousands of people that have worked really, really hard to make dual mode 5G core possible.
First step on the journey, it started in 2016 when we made the decision to develop the future of core was cloud native. We were looking at the market and did see that the EPC and 5G core would coexist for many years. And then we made the decisions to go for dual mode 5G core networks.
We created a 5G core trial program that was instrumental to approach our customers for them to try them out and give us a quick feedback.
There was somebody on managing requirements for our 5G core product came to me with an Excel list. But then when we printed this out, they were 2.5-3 meters long. That brings back some fun memories.
The second step was to kick off an application development program called ADP to create a set of microservices that were going to be reused across all portfolio. Due to the complexity of cloud native, we needed to invest a lot more in serviceability, automation, and optimization in order to improve the total cost of ownership.
So we launched the first EPC networks in the US 2019, and there we could see that our architectural decisions paid off. Secondly, we went live in Australia, also there with cloud native EPC with very good results.
We were the first in the markets, and being the first means that you need to experience a lot of problems for the first time and solve them along the way.
To make the first call on standalone was very easy, but really then to make all the networks harden and reach all the needed KPIs for a mobile broadband service took us a very long time. But now we've reached a good quality level, proven by multiple 9 networks in commercial operation.
Our customer successes helped us to move forward in our technology and innovation. We provide built-in value-added services like video optimization, built-in software probes, network address translation that can all be in one single node.
We have now migrated within several operators all of their subscribers for EPC, meaning tens of millions of subscribers over to cloud native 5G core.
So now many pioneering service providers are live with Ericsson dual mode 5G core, and they are delivering great experience to 5G smartphones and fixed wireless access.
Our software supports in-service software upgrades, microservice by microservice, without offloading any traffic, without end-user impacts. Service providers can also benefit from high-density CPUs, and thereby offer higher performance with better energy efficiency within using even less service than before. But we've also leveraged the software for new things such as local packet gateway, enabling new services to be launched. It's really time to take the next steps and start to leverage all of the new technology enablers. This comes with network slicing, edge compute, critical IoT, RedCap, and exposure. This is really what is going to bring forward the true value of 5G core. It's been a very challenging journey, but it's been totally worthwhile.
We are so proud of what we have achieved so far that we will continue to take it to the next level.